YouTube, Red Viking Trucker. I want to talk about scaling your load and the importance of it, especially since I got banged a week and a half ago for being overweight. But this happened to me this week. It's never happened before. I want to share it with you. Went and picked up a load, the bill of lading from the company. I've never picked up there before. It was new for me. The bill of lading said it was 42,000 pounds. Well, at 42,000 pounds plus my tractor, which is, let's just say, 12.5, and my trailer at 22.4 empty, I should have been around 77,000 pounds total. So I should have been 3,000 pounds under the 80,000 pound limit. And then when I get to the scale, I balance it out to make sure that I've got no more than 34 on the rear drive for the trailer and the tandems for the trailer. So each of those two sets of wheels, the rear drive for the tractor and the tandems for the trailer, they can't be supporting more than 34,000 pounds each. And then up to 12.5 for the tractor with me in it, with the gas. The DOT allows you a little bit of flexibility because of the tri-pack. But at their math, what they claimed was 42,000 loaded, I should have been 2,000-3,000 pounds under the 80,000 pound limit. Well, I get to the scale and I scale the load within the first 5 miles of leaving the shipper, I'm at 83,000 pounds. So I'm 3,000 pounds over the 80,000 limit, and I'm also 6,000 pounds over what they said they loaded in my trailer. Here's the important thing, because I tend to, I'm very friendly with people when I meet them. So when I went back and I said, hey, I showed them the scale ticket. I said, I'm 3,000 pounds over the limit. I said, but it also seems like it's a little bit more weight than what you said, because at 42,000 pounds, I should only have about 77,000 pounds on my weight ticket. I've got 83, so I'm 6,000 pounds over, even from what you said you loaded in. Well, while I was sitting there, the guy that loaded it, he was at the other end of the shipping complex. He was coming over in his forklift. Another guy who had been there kind of in and out of the deal for whether they were loading, this guy's talking to me, and I said, yes, it just seems odd to see, because the bill of lading says it's 42,000 pounds, but it's got to be at least almost 50. You know, 49, 50. He's like, well, how many stacks did they give you? And I told him how many it was. He said, it was 35 stacks of their product. He said, we normally only put 30 in. Why? He put 35 in. So what they had done, I don't know if it was intentional or not, but I'm telling you guys, you got to protect yourself. Because if I had been arrogant still and looked at that and thought 42,000 pounds, I'll set my tandem at about 7, 8, or 9 whole, and I'm on the way, I would have gotten another weight ticket violation for being 3,000 pounds over the 80,000 pound limit. That would have crushed me just out of the sheer frustration of having it happen twice within 2 weeks. Luckily, I stopped and scaled it. But the other thing is, I wonder if they knew it. I wonder if he knew that they normally put 30, but they were trying to sneak another 5 in there and then just tell me it was 42,000 pounds and hope I'd go ahead and drive on down the road. Because if they load it up and say it's 42,000 pounds and I don't check, it's on me. So he had loaded 5 pallets more on my truck than what the normal weight distribution was from what his partner accidentally told me. And it really, really set me back on my heels, because I realized at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who you talk to, doesn't matter what they say, it's your responsibility. You got to scale your load. You have to do your pre-trip inspection. It's on you. It's on nobody else. Once that truck starts moving and you take ownership and say, I'm good to go, it's on you. And you shouldn't let, people shouldn't do that, because it ended up costing me another hour and a half of my time having to go back and have them unload and restack and do things. But it was kind of eye-opening, because I was so far overweight, and yet I looked at the bill of lading and I was believing what it said. And just one more tip out here for being a big rig, over-the-road, 18-wheel truck driver. When you scale your loads, and when you're at these shippers, doesn't matter what they put on the piece of paper, you got to check. You got to check the seal yourself. You have to check the weight yourself before you start heading down the road thinking you're good, before arrogance kicks in. Just one more tip. It saved me probably, because from where I picked up to where I was going, I went through 5 weigh stations. So I would have gotten banged again had I believed that I was okay with what they had on the bill of lading, which was incorrect. So just pay attention. Understand it's your business. It's your livelihood, and once you start rolling, saying everything is good, if it's not good, it falls back on you, just like it falls back on me. So just another tip, because it was something that happened this week that was kind of unique. Thanks for watching. If you like these videos, please subscribe, like, and comment. And remember, man, none of us get out of here alive, so what are you waiting on? Come on. Be good.